Okay, so welcome again to Military Guna TV. I am your host, Mario Dickers. And so all those who are Arsenal supporters and want to see my review, or my review of the game, I posted a link in the community chat for a channel called Jamaican Gunas, or Jamaican Gunas, which it entitles, it's targeting Arsenal fans that are Jamaican in yard and abroad. That's the whole concept. So you guys can go and check that out if you're an Arsenal fan and go and subscribe to that channel. Definitely I will try to give you guys more regular content. You see a lot of different faces on that channel as well because it entails a lot of different people. Now, please guys, remember to smash the like button and turn on your notification. When you hit the subscribe button, we're going to speak about two reggae boys, Ethan Pinnock and Kemar Roofe. Now, let me start off with I'm trying to balance the people. I want to know where should I start at, because I have mixed feelings about the Ethan Pinnock's performance, and I'm feeling extremely well about the Kemar Roofe performance. So I'm not sure if I should start with the good or the bad. So here what? Let me start off with Kemar Roofe. Definitely start off with Kemar Roofe. Kemar Roofe scored a brace today, people. I'm not sure if many of you guys know about it, because that game was actually it was not the most talked about game, but it was in the Scottish Cup, the Scottish League Cup, their League Cup round of 16. They played against Dunfermline. You can imagine Dunfermline. They played against Dunfermline. Very, very good performance from Kemar Roofe. He scored a penalty and also an open goal. But he put in an exceptional performance, and he's back on the pitch, and he was lauded by all the media platform about this performance in particular. Why is my laptop not charging? In particular, he was extremely lauded for this performance because he gave it his all. He really get down into it. I didn't watch the match. I had to re-watch the game because I was watching Ethan Pinnock. I'm not sure who Ethan Pinnock was playing against, but I was watching Ethan Pinnock. So I had to rewatch the game when it finished. So literally, I just finished watching the game about half an hour or so. Yeah, but it was a solid performance from a very, very good performance from Kemar Roofe, and he's actually scoring a lot of goals. He is scoring a lot of goals since preseason. This guy has been hitting the bag time and time again. He's now tallying, looking towards like possible, based off his scoring ratio, possible like 25 plus goal for this season overall. So we will see a lot more to come from Kemar Roofe in the going, moving forward. Now, there's a few things that I realized with him. He tends to drag. Well, he's a second striker. I'm not sure if most of you guys know that Kemar Roofe plays as a second striker. But what he does, he drags to the right and to the left and support the other players. Because if you guys check out his passing stats, all those things are very, very good. Very, very high passing stats and all those aspects of things. Now, but goes to show that we have a lot of options in regards to our strike force, because I was watching him look really, really well. Really, really good. Good interchanging pass between him and Wright and Inzaghi and Haji, the young lad. Now, but let's move away from that. Rangers slapped Dunfermline 5-0 in the Scotland League Cup round of 16, where Kemar Roofe was the man of the match. He's the most outstanding player on the pitch, I would say. And he really, really led the front line quite good. But definitely, it was a good performance from Kemar Roofe. Let's move away from that now into... So that's the good news. Let's move away into the mixed feelings, the good and bad. It's good and bad for me. Let me explain to you the reason why it's good and bad for me. I can't move. Get up from here now, and I'll show you why it's good and bad. So as you guys know, I'm a big, massive Arsenal supporter, and no, I was watching this game, right? I'm in full support of the Reggae Boys, 100% support of the Reggae Boys, but not when they're playing against Arsenal. Not when they're playing against Arsenal. I want them to have bad games when they're playing against Arsenal. Yes, you guys can say this, or you guys can say all that you want. But for some reason, this is the first game of the league, first match of the league season, first match of the season, all of those things. And this is a game that Ethan Pinnock decided that he wants to turn into a Van Dijk. My word. The guy was a beast. Ethan Pinnock was a beast. He locked down every single thing. He locked down every single player. And I'm being honest. I was pretty much upset. I was screaming at the forward to get at him to not play the ball down his channel. Because he was so dominant, I was asking the players to not play the ball down his channel. Now, statistically, it is not the best, because if you guys should know that Arsenal had most of the possession, but statistically it was not the best of game for him on a statistical aspect, statistics. But performance, if you guys just watch that performance, you definitely understand what I'm talking about. And I was screaming at the TV saying, play down on the left channel. Do not go to the right-hand channel where Ethan Pinnock is. Go to the left channel, because that defender looked a bit more subjected to creating an error or causing himself an error leading to a goal. And we consistently go down that side. Ethan Pinnock had a £72 million player unlock. He had one of the young starlets in the Arsenal football team, which is Forlan Balogun. The 72 players, Nicolas Pepe, he had Forlan Balogun unlocked. This guy was a beast out on the pitch. No, the next player, regular boy prospect, Ivan Toney. Guys, I'm telling you, he has some very, very good touches. Wonderful work rate, extreme work rate. And I'm really impressed. I'm being honest, I'm 100% impressed. I am now questioning how this selection for the defense will go, because I am looking at this Ethan Pinnock. And I'm saying, if these are the performances that the Reggae Boys will be getting from Ethan Pinnock, they will be getting exceptional performances that can really take us to our next level. He was outstanding. He was solid. He was exceptional. He was really, really rugged in this game. Even the commentators were consistently talking about him. And the reason why I saw what he's doing, it's because I was watching as an opposition, not as supporting him. I was not watching as supporting him. If I was supporting him, I would have said that there can be a bit of bias. But the mere fact that I was opposing to what he was doing shows how well he was playing. He was the best defender on the pitch for them. He was the one who was commanding the back line. He was the one who actually telling the team to press a bit higher, when to drop off, when to close the spaces, and also when to open the pitch. His experience going down when he needs to, I'm collecting some silly fouls. He was really, really putting in some good performance, and I was enjoying it. I was enjoying his performance, but not enjoying the game. I was totally devastated by the game. So let me just run through his stats so you guys can see. Total minutes played, 90. He has an assist, 4 clearances, 2 block shots, 1 interception, 1 tackle. He was dribbled past twice. That's relatively expected. Ground duels, he encountered in 6. He won 3. 2 aerial duels, 1. And he encountered in 4. Why did this thing came off? What just happened? Anyways, people, I have no clue reason why that came up. Maybe you guys should not see the rest of the stats. Hopefully you guys saw the rest. No, I can't do that. I have to bring it up. Good. It's coming back up now, people. Sorry about that. My apologies. My astute apologies, people. I don't know what happened. He just decided that he just want to walk away. Goes to show that it's just that's the day that I'm having, guys. That's it. I'm having a mad day. Arsenal Football Club really, really disturbed my day. So he lost possession 17 times, which I believe was a lot. High press system would have caused that, and I think that's something that he has to work on. He was fouled once. He had 58 touches, passing percentile of 66%. He attempted 35 passes, completing 23 out of those. Needs to work on that. He had 1 key pass. He attempted 7 long balls with 2 completed, and he made 1 successful dribble. As you guys can see from the heat map, he was literally supporting even the left wing back moving, pushing forward as a central midfielder. But in all aspect, people, it was a solid performance from Ethan Pinnock. We cannot take that away from him. Exceptional performance from Ethan Pinnock. And I did enjoy that performance from him, but I did not enjoy the game, people. I did not enjoy the game. People, can you imagine I'm predicting Arsenal to win 2-0? Just let that soak in. I predicted Arsenal to win that game 2-0. So the next time, next prediction, I'm going to say Arsenal's going to lose. So hopefully we're going to win. And we're going to play Chelsea. So Dre, any other sports? Oh, my word. Do not DM me. Do not DM me, bro. But massive respect, people. Thank you very much for tuning in. This has been a good one. Hopefully, guys are okay. Please enjoy the rest of your night. And this has been Military Guna TV, people. Peace out. I am out.